they've gone behind the car, everybody. You can't help this sometimes. Wow, he got moving before the rest of them. Yeah, indeed. He wants to go claim the best shade. He was sitting out there and the sun suddenly materialized on him and he realized, uh-oh, let me go find a nice cool spot. And right where he is there would be quite suitable. They're probably going to go into the drainage. This is the drainage between Pangolin and Ingwe Alley. Very tricky little area to access. They might just find a little bit of a gwarry thicket on the banks and settle down there for the day. It is even possible that Amber Eyes and the other two lioness have decided to try and ferret out some food. And they keep quiet. Great is that, everybody. Just want some milk, Mum. That's all we want. I said no. Joining us in the sighting, of course. Has fled into the thickets. Ridgenose and the other young lioness came out. This is Purple Eye getting all the attention. And there's Ridgenose to the right. Shannon, I'm not really sure when the vocal cords get fully developed. It's kind of like, I suppose, in humans at a certain age, at puberty, that they talk about boys when their testicles drop, the voice changes. It's probably a similar sort of thing, but you definitely hear lionesses and young male lions help roaring in the pride after a year and a half, 2 years. 2 years probably is about as early as I've heard them roaring with the pride. So it's possibly about that sort of stage, but I'm not 100% sure on the actual development of it. Now, Ridgenose is getting all the attention. No, Now that sound, everybody, if you're walking and you hear that, don't go forward. I can promise you, you stop and you walk backwards very slowly. But you will hear that sound if you're walking, if the lion isn't happy with you, hear that. If you don't, you need to take out your earplugs. You shouldn't be walking with earplugs. If you hear all those little cub noises, hey, you better get out of there. Come on, Mama, just lie down so we can get some milk. Hungry. Sunsilk waters, yes. The younger cubs are obviously more dependent on the milk than the older ones will be. So lionesses will sort of stop providing them with the milk anywhere from 7 months to 10 months, 10 months being sort of the end of the line. And no doubt the two older cubs will push that boundary as long as they possibly can. There's only about 2 months between them, so they will definitely try and milk it as long as they can. There's a fur ball being regurgitated. But you're going to start seeing that the lioness is just rejecting them more and more and more, and eventually the cubs will give up even trying. There you go, Purple Eye. You're going to go back over to the shade there. Find a nice patch. No doubt, one by one, the cubs will start following. Oh yeah. It's just incessant, isn't it? They just don't stop. You see how she's not happy, she's rejecting. And they learn, okay, what did I do wrong? Sorry. Try again. Going to be staying here with these lions. In the meantime, Lauren is looking at some tracks on the ground.